Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Quran Weekly, this is your brother Umar Sulaiman, and we're continuing now with the Superstar series. Now, when we look in the seerah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, there are two names that are often associated together. In fact, you could make the argument that they're always associated together. And those are Talha ibn Ubaidillah and Zubair al-Awwam radiallahu anhumah. Both of these sahaba held a very, very special place with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. In fact, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said about Talha and Zubair that they are both my neighbors in Jannah. Jaraya fil Jannah. They are going to be my neighbors in paradise. So let's take a quick look at the life of Talha radiallahu anhu and the special quality that we can take from his life. Talha radiallahu anhu, he tells the story of his own Islam. He's from the same tribe of Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu, the tribe of Taym, and he was a tradesman. So he says that he was in Syria when he saw that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had left Asham, and a monk had informed Talha radiallahu ta'ala anhu that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was indeed a messenger of Allah. So Talha made his way back to Mecca and he asked the people, he said, "What happened while I was gone?" So they said, "Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam has claimed prophethood." So Talha radiallahu anhu, he went to his relative Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu and he said, "Have you heard about what Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is saying?" And he said, "Yes." And Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu said, "He is calling to the truth and you should follow him also." So Talha said, "I became Muslim." Now Talha and Abu Bakr were both high men in their society. Talha radiallahu anhu being younger, he was only 18 years old. But both of them would have to be tortured. And what the Quraysh would do with the high people in society is they wouldn't torture them out in public, but they would assign them to their relatives. So the person that was in charge of torturing both Abu Bakr and Talha was Nawfal ibn Khuwaylid, the brother of Khadija radiallahu ta'ala anha, who tied both Talha and Abu Bakr up, and he would torture them every single day. And in fact, Talha and Abu Bakr, may Allah be pleased with them, gained the nicknames Al-Qarinain, the two Qareens, the two close friends, those who were tied together, because they were tied together so frequently whenever they would be tortured by Nawfal. Now if we look at their lives, and if we look at the life of Talha radiallahu anhu in particular, the specific characteristic, the specific trait that always stands out is the trait of Ihsan, pure excellence. Talha radiallahu anhu excelled in everything that he did. He was known for his generosity, so much so that Sa'id ibn Zayd, one of the other Ashar Mubashireen, 10 Promised Paradise, he says radiallahu anhu that I traveled with Talha on journeys. I have never seen a person more generous than him in his food and his water and in his clothing. And Talha radiallahu anhu, in fact, was given three nicknames by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam because of his frequent charity, because how he would always, you know, stand out and he would always be the one to excel. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam named Talha, Talhatul Khair, Talhatul Jud, and Talhatul Fayyad. All three of them having similar meanings. Talhatul Khair, Talha the excellent, Talhatul Jud, Talha the benevolent, Talhatul Fayyad, Talha the one who was excessively generous. So Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam even recognized those special traits of Talha radiallahu anhu, as did the Sahaba. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with them all. But the specific incident that you look at with Talha radiallahu anhu to truly understand his excellence and his ihsan and his always going overboard, always going a step further to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, was the day of Uhud. The day that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was hurt, had the rings of his helmet sallallahu alaihi wasallam driven into his cheeks, had his front teeth knocked out sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When Talha radiallahu ta'ala anhu heard that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was being attacked, he ran to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and he defended the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, so much so that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he would say later on, he would say, "You should have seen me on the day of Uhud. On my right was Jibreel alayhi salam, on my left was Talha radiallahu ta'ala anhu." And in fact, Talha, may Allah be pleased with him, when he ran to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was being attacked, an arrow was shot at the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and Talha radiallahu ta'ala anhu extended his hand and he allowed that arrow to hit his hand, and because of that his hand became paralyzed. He then took his other arm and he put the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam over his shoulder and he guarded the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and tried to escape that area where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was being attacked. And his daughter, she says that my father on that day suffered 24 wounds to his body. When Talha radiallahu anhu finally took the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to safety, He laid the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam down, and then he fell unconscious because of all of the blood that was coming from him. Abu Bakr and Sa'd, may Allah be pleased with them both, they said, we ran to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam directed us to go to Talha radiallahu anhu. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was there, and he was just staring at Talha radiallahu anhu, and he was just admiring the effort that Talha radiallahu ta'ala anhu put in. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said something very special about Talha. He said right then and there, من أراد أن ينظر إلى شهيد يمشي على رجليه فلينظر إلى طلحة بن عبيد الله. Whoever wants to see a martyr, a walking and living martyr, walking on his two feet, then let him look at Talha رضي الله تعالى عنه and admire him. So subhanAllah, you imagine he already had those nicknames, and he also now gains the nickname of the walking shaheed, the living martyr. And Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, in fact, when he used to look at the day of Uhud, when he used to reflect on the day of Uhud, he said, ذَاكَ يَوْمُ طَلْحَ. The day of Uhud is the day of Talha radiallahu ta'ala anhu. You know, because of how special the sacrifice of Talha radiallahu anhu was that day. So Talha, like the others, he served with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in every battle except for Badr. And because he was with Sa'id ibn Zayd radiallahu anhum, and they were scouting in the area of Ash-Sham when the Battle of Badr took place, and by the time they got back, the battle had already finished. And Talha radiallahu anhu, he asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, do I have my reward, O Rasulullah? And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, laka sahmuk, you have your reward. Talha radiallahu anhu, he wasn't necessarily thinking of the spoils of war, because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam mentioned the spoils of war there, laka sahmuk. Talha radiallahu anhu was a person of ihsan. He was thinking about something totally different. He said, wa ajri ya Rasulullah, and my reward in akhirah, O Prophet of Allah. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, wa laka ajruk, and you have your ajr. So that shows you the mentality of Talha radiallahu ta'ala anhu. He wasn't just concerned about the spoils, he was concerned about the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so we can look back on the day of Uhud, the day that many people fled from the side of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and we know that is the day of Talha radiallahu ta'ala anhu, because he was standing there with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, shielding the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And this was Talha radiallahu anhu. Every time Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam made a call for anything, Talha was always the first one to volunteer himself, whether it was sadaqah, whether it was his own life, or whatever it may have been. Talha radiallahu anhu was always the first one to come forward to strive in the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And even unfortunately, towards the end of his life, Talha radiallahu ta'ala anhu witnessed the murder of Uthman radiallahu anhu. And this murder, it hurt him so much. It hurt him so much. I mean, Talha loved Uthman. He sent his own son Muhammad to stand at the door of Uthman radiallahu anhu whenever the house of Uthman was under siege. And so whenever Uthman was assassinated, Talha radiallahu anhu was from the people of Aisha, the army of Aisha radiallahu anha, who was demanding that the killers of Uthman be pursued. And whenever Aisha radiallahu anha and Talha and Zubair, may Allah be pleased with them both, came to meet with Ali radiallahu anhu, and they asked Ali to pursue the killers of Uthman. And they came to an agreement amongst each other. As we know, Abdullah ibn Saba had both the camp of Aisha and the camp of Ali attacked. And because of that, a battle ensued between the army of Aisha and the army of Ali, may Allah be pleased with them both. Both of them not intending to hurt the other, both of them not intending to cause to have this battle, but both thinking that they were attacked. And Talha radiallahu anhu, he was only there because of his love for Uthman. In fact, this was his ihsan. He made the dua. He said, Allahumma khudh minni li Uthman. Oh Allah, take from me for Uthman hatta tarda, until you are pleased. And Talha radiallahu ta'ala anhu was murdered on that day. He was killed on that day. And Ali radiallahu anhu, he came to Talha and he wiped his face and he started to cry and he kissed him on the forehead and he said, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make you and I amongst those who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَنَزَعْنَا مَا فِي قُلُوبِهِم مِّن غِلٍّ إِخْوَانًا عَلَىٰ سُرُرٍ مُتَقَابِلِينَ. And we have taken from their hearts all forms of grudges, everything that they had against each other, and we made them brothers on thrones, on high couches, متقابلين, staring at one another in al-Jannah. So this was Talha radiallahu anhu, the person who always went the extra step, who always wanted to make sure he did everything with ihsan. So I ask you, whenever you do something, whenever you give sadaqah, whenever you do anything for the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how much are you really putting into it? How much ihsan is there in it? How much excellence is there in it? And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow us to be joined with Talha radiallahu anhu, after all, as he is a neighbor of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Jannat al-Firdaus. So we ask Allah to allow us to be their neighbors in Jannat al-Firdaus. Allahumma ameen. I'll see you next week inshallah for the Superstar series. Jazakum Allahu khairan. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.